So you want to take all your Minecraft worlds and make one giant world.
Well, since Minecraft introduced biome blending in Minecraft 1.18, we can use some software to import chunks from one world into another and make it look naturally generated. Let's look at how.
We'll be working with two villages in two different worlds today. This is on world 1, and this is the other village on world 2.
By the end, both of these villages should be on the same world with a seamless blend between the two sides like this. We're only going to need two things. One, all the Minecraft worlds you want to merge together, and two, MCA Selector, which is the application we'll be using to do the actual merging. For your world files, single player worlds can be found here, and multiplayer worlds are normally found here. Make sure to make backups of your original save files and to not make edits to your original files, because any changes made to them will be permanent. Make copies of your original save files and put them in a separate folder. These are the files that we'll be editing. Mine will be on my desktop.
Next up, head over to the link in the description and scroll down a bit until you see the installer link. Click on it and let it download. It should only take a couple seconds. Then, go ahead and install the program.
Once you have the application open, go over to File, Open World, and find your worlds and pick one of them. If you see something like this, one of them is going to be your overworld, one will be your nether, and one will be your end. Click world 1, whatever's on top, and it should open up. And what you're going to see is a top-down view of every generated chunk in your world. What you want to do is select every chunk that you don't want and delete it. That way you're only left with the chunks you want. There's a lot of ways to do that. You can manually click and drag to select all the chunks you want to keep. Click invert and then delete all the chunks you don't want. I think one really easy way to do it is just go over to tools, filter chunks, and use this. Inhabited time is less than 5 minutes. That pretty much just means every chunk that's been inhabited for less than 5 minutes will get selected. So I think a good amount of time is 20 minutes. Pretty much we've been on the server for a long time. In my case, any chunk that hasn't been inhabited for more than 20 minutes probably doesn't have anything on it. And there we go. That's pretty much every chunk that isn't worth anything to me. We can go to selection and delete, or control D. And they're deleted. For the purpose of the video, I'm just going to select this small little chunk right here just to make it easy on us. I'm going to go to invert, go to invert and then delete chunks. Once that's done, go ahead, open up MCA Selector again and do this for your other map. You want to make sure you have two windows open for this. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm just going to select what really matters to me, which is sort of this area. Minus that. Invert. Delete. Now you have two maps with chunks that you just want. What you want to do is select every chunk from here. If you're too zoomed out, it will sort of grab a whole bunch of chunks. Go to copy or just press Control C. Go over to the other map and then press Control V or paste. And here you can just drag it wherever you want. I'm going to put it to the side. Just make sure whenever you paste your chunks to leave a little blank space in between. This is the space that will generate new terrain and blend with the existing edges. And there you go. You have your two maps together on world. All the empty space in between will generate chunks based on whatever update you load the map in. So for me, it's going to be 1.19 chunks. At this part, you can also add as many different chunks from different worlds as you want. And if it works correctly, all the empty space or black squares should blend in with the existing edges. Again, I made my map like this only to make the tutorial simpler. In actuality, your map is going to look more like this. There's going to be a lot of irregular shapes. There is an art to this, and there are certain things to avoid to make your world look as natural as possible that I'll get to at the end of the video. But for now, let's see what this world looks like. Once you're done, go ahead and grab the folder of the world that you edited and put it back into your saves folder. All right, so once you load into your world, you should see everything on one map. Over here, you can see what was our world 1. If we go over to the left a little bit, you can see our world 2, which was sort of like the wheat field and the little floating islands over there. Now, there are a few things to look out for.
Below me is the line between the old map and the newly generated chunks. And it looks good until I move up a little bit. Now, you can see a hard line between the two sides. This is pretty much because snow didn't generate on the new terrain for whatever reason. I'm going to assume it's because of the biome change, which also raised the height at which rain turns into snow, which you can see here. This leads into my next two tips. Tip number one, whenever you're selecting the chunks you want to keep, avoid selecting really long lines like this. Pretty much, don't do what I did earlier because this will make any differences between the old chunks and the new generation really noticeable as we saw earlier. Even if most of the generation looks good, the small negligible differences will add up if they all occur on the same line. If you go the filtered chunks route, however, you'll typically end up with something like this, with feathered edges around the sides that make it harder to notice any differences. And tip number two, avoid cutting through snow if you can. At least for me, snow is still a little buggy, and it may be different for you. It also may be different in the future, but you know, you can try it for yourself if you want to, but if it doesn't work, I would say just go around it. And tip number three, trees are going to be a little weird too. I think this one's less important because you can hardly notice it if you aren't looking for it, but once you do spot it, it's hard to ignore it. You can see that if you cut through the leaves of a tree, whenever you're deleting chunks, the new generation won't fill those leaves back in. This goes back to my first tip. Because there's all these small errors on a giant line, it makes all of them more noticeable. So I know I keep going on about avoiding straight lines. Let me actually show you what I mean when I say that. Instead of selecting a giant rectangle like this, instead, get something with more irregular edges like this. Again, edges like this typically occur naturally whenever you filter chunks by inhabited time. Let me show you what this actually looks like when it's loaded and generated in-game. Keep an eye on the small pool of lava at the bottom right as a point of reference. Once you load in, it actually looks pretty good. At a glance, it's hard to notice any errors. The area with the lake and the flatland I think generated perfectly. As far as the forest, you can see the issues with the trees I mentioned earlier. But again, because the missing blocks are spread out and not lined up, most people probably wouldn't notice it on a regular stroll through the woods. Alright, with all that covered, here's my final point before I move on. Don't stress too much about the small errors that come when you merge. In a nearly infinitely generated world, these errors will be a tiny fraction of what you interact with. If you really need it to be perfect, you could go in and touch up the edges with something like World Edit if you wanted to. Final thing, if for whatever reason your chunks aren't blending, which happened to me at one point, you may end up seeing something like this. If that's happening to you, there's a way to force the chunks to blend into the new terrain. The first thing you want to do is delete all the newly generated chunks. We do this so we can regenerate them with the correct blending. An easy way to do that is to filter chunks by inhabited time less than 1 minute. Double check you aren't deleting any important chunks, then delete them so that you're just left with the chunks you started with. Now, select all the generated chunks on the map. You can do this by filtering chunks by inhabited time greater than 0 minutes. This should select every chunk on the map. Finally, go to Tools, Change Fields, then scroll down to Force Blend. Put a 1 in the box and press OK. This is actually going to change the data of every one of those chunks, so be careful with this. Make sure when you do this not to have any empty squares or black squares selected when you go to change that field. This will corrupt that block so that anytime you try to load in the game, it'll crash the server or the game. So again, only change this field on chunks that are already generated. Alright, so that's the end of the video. I hope it was helpful and I hope I made it clear. Like and subscribe if you want, but I'm probably never making another video like this again.